name is Joe Weir, and I'm with Grapplemonster Wrestling Gear. I'm the owner, and I'm just coming to you today trying to talk a little bit about coaching strategies and ways to train your brain. I think that's the biggest part about wrestling that we leave out. I've been coaching for about 24 years, and so I do have a little bit of insight, and I've coached everybody from national champs all the way down to a kid that hasn't won a match in a single season. So I've had the whole gamut, and I just would talk to you about a little bit of a theme today. And my theme today is just something simple, something everybody loves. That's right, ice cream. Everybody loves ice cream. And if you think about wrestling or you think about sports in general, and you know, you think about how it's just like ice cream. We all want something sweet. We want something that is going to be amazing for us. We want something that's going to be a pinnacle of success, that we're going to climb that mountain somehow. And so if you think about ice cream's kind of like that. It's the sweetness. It's the end of a great meal. It's you know, maybe just an extra snack after you're done with everything for the day. And so it's just that extra sweet, special time, maybe special time with friends and family. But in wrestling, we got to realize that there's a price, right? And not many of us think about where ice cream comes from and how that actually gets produced. But if you start thinking about it, you think about how they had to harvest sugarcane in the fields, and how the cows had to be grown from a little baby calf to a full-blown dairy cow, and then actually milked to produce that ice cream as well. Then you had to have the rock salt that was actually mined and broken up and chopped up into bits and pieces from, you know, the hard work and labor of the miners. And so you have to understand that there are a lot of components that go into this one sweet thing. And it didn't just happen magically. It happened from a lot of blood, sweat, and tears, and a lot of people making a commitment to excellence, to whether, no matter what kinds you like, to make that ice cream. And if you act, you know, add in toppings, obviously then you have more stuff. You have more variables that you're talking about. So when you think about ice cream, I got a couple, five different ideas that you have to kind of follow. Number one is, if you want anything sweet, you got to set your dream on something sweet. So number one is set your dream high. Set your dream on something sweet, something that you know is attainable, but that's sweet. That's going to be your pinnacle. It could be, for some kids, it might be having a winning record. Other kids, it might be winning a state championship. Other kids might be winning a national championship. But set it on something that's high enough that it's going to make you work hard, but also something that's attainable in your short and long term planning. The other thing is, number two, is to actually make that plan. Make that plan happen. You know, start living it. That's what it is. Make the plan happen by start living it. The sooner that you can start mining that rock salt, and the sooner you can start raising that cow, the sooner you're going to be in a successful, sweet situation to make that ice cream. The third thing is, you got to start gathering ingredients. You have to get tools, and you know, those tools are going to help make things. For example, you got to get the calf, and you have to get the sugar cane, and you're going to have to mine the salt. So you have to start gathering. And in wrestling, these are different tools, whether it be mental or physical. Positioning in wrestling, everybody from the lowest level on up knows positioning is important in wrestling. And if you go to a college wrestling room, 1 month into the event, they're still working on positioning. In our high school rooms, in our youth rooms, we're hitting move after move after move. We want a $10 move. But in the college rooms, they're still working on positioning, because great positioning sets you up for everything else. Everybody in the country pretty much knows a double leg takedown that's been in the wrestling room for a year. Every single person. So what makes one person better than the other is the positioning and setups that go along with it. So you got to plan it out and set it up. So gather those ingredients, gather them, and start putting them together. What you need to realize is, step number four, is putting things together is not easy. In order for you to be amazingly successful, you have to outwork thousands when nobody's watching. And then you'll have the ability to compete in front of thousands when everybody's watching. And that's a quote from Jordan Burroughs, actually. But every single person out there, every single person is somebody that can work and get to an attainable high level. Doesn't mean every kid's going to be a state champ. We all know that's not the case. I've had kids that had a zero win record in their eighth grade year and they wrestle in college. That is a huge victory, and that's credit to the kid for not giving up and for grinding through it. So that process is not easy. And anybody that tells you it's going to be easy is telling you dead wrong. That's the reason why we call wrestlers one percenters. We're the top 1% of everybody out there, because only 1% of the population can do what we do. It's also the reason why wrestlers are traditionally successful in everything they do, because they know how to outwork people. And that's what we're teaching kids over and over again. The fifth thing is you got to finish the dream. And when you finish the dream to get the sweetness, You have to realize that it's this dream is going to take the mental fortitude to do it. And the way you finish is through the mind. You'll have all the tools. About halfway through the dream, a lot of times kids have the tools. But training your brain into believing that you can go out there and execute at the highest level is something that takes time. It takes practice. And it should be part of your practice strategy. There should be a coach speech. There should be some goal setting. There should be a lot of things that you have to do as a coach to make the kids train their brain to think the right way. Just like we train our bodies. We train our bodies muscle memory. Our bodies remember what we do over and over again. Our mind does the same thing. And one of my daughter is a high-level gymnast. And one of the things that I've learned from that situation, she had a few mental problems for a while, and she went to a sports psychologist, and they said, hey, thinking of bad things is like thinking of a pink elephant. So everybody thinks of a pink elephant, right? And it pops in your head, and you're not going to get rid of that thought, just like we're not going to get rid of negativity very easily. What you have to do is you have to take positive thoughts and you have to push it out of the way. So now if you think of a blue hot air balloon pushing that pink elephant out of your head, that is an example of how we have to take those negative thoughts and we replacement with positive thoughts. Okay, we're not worried about what that other guy is going to hit on us. He can't stop our double leg. Those kinds of things are what make you great. So hope this helped you a little bit today. Hope you enjoy your ice cream. I know that I'm going to here in a second. It's going to be nice and mushy, which is my favorite kind. Enjoy your day.